What is the best way to fulfill your dreams? We all have dreams, hopes, wishes for ourselves. What is the best way to go about achieving them? Joseph in Parshat Miketz continues to do what he always did, interpret dreams. Dreams got him into trouble and dreams got him out of trouble. Dreams brought upon him self-hatred and dreams made him loved. He was even called Baal HaChalomot, the dreamer. I would like to share with you a thought my father said under my chuppah. You see, Joseph had 6 dreams associated with his name in Genesis, all of which he interpreted. When he was 17 years old, he has his first dream, where he sees that he was binding sheaves in the field, and all of his brother's sheaves end up bowing down to his. The brothers were furious, asking him, "Do you really think you'll rule over us?" In the second dream, he envisions the sun, moon, and 11 stars bowing down to him. This time, even his father Jacob criticizes him for insinuating that his parents, including his mother, who has already passed away, will bow down to him. The third dream was presented to him when he was in prison, after being wrongly accused for attacking Potiphar's wife. His fellow inmate, the cupbearer, shares with him his dream where he sees 3 barely ripened grape branches, from which he makes wine and serves it to the Pharaoh. Joseph explains to him that the 3 branches represent the 3 days in which he will be returned to his post. Then another inmate, the chief baker, decides to share his dream as well. He sees 3 baskets on his head, and the birds were eating from them. Joseph replies that unfortunately he will be put to death in 3 days, and that is exactly how things play out. And then, the 5th and 6th dream, Pharaoh calls on him to interpret his own dreams. He shares with him his vision of 7 fat and skinny cows arising from the Nile, following which the skinny cows eat the fat ones. And finally, a similar vision of 7 healthy crops being replaced by thin ones, to which Joseph explains to Pharaoh how to prepare for the upcoming famine. This time, not only does he interpret the dreams, but he is also placed in charge of executing their meaning. Now look at the evolution of Joseph. First, he is focused on his own dreams, but slowly, as he grows older, he learns to listen to other people's dreams as well. Like when he noticed the cupbearer and chief baker with depressed faces, he asked, "Madua pnechem ra'im? Why are your faces down?" Instead of focusing on making his dreams come true, he helps Pharaoh and the Egyptian people make sure they never suffer the consequences of their nightmares. Someone once told me that the best way to forget about your own tzaras, problems, is to occupy yourself with helping others solve theirs. Joseph's dreams came true only after he made others' dreams materialize as well. This is, in essence, the meaning of the master of dreams, Baal HaChalomot. Let us aspire to be that Baal HaChalomot, master of dreams in plural, to not only focus inward, but to think big, to dream for others as well.